So Girl on the Shore will be the next manga I'll be reviewing on the channel, and for this video I'll be covering the first 5 chapters in my first impressions. And I was debating on making this video actually, considering how short this manga is, only 20 chapters, and I might have just done what I did with Jujutsu Kaisen Volume 0, only doing the review, but the chapters were a decent length, so I decided why not. And another thing I want to answer is why this manga. You know, it's not particularly well known, and that's because this is the same writer as the manga Punpun, and I've heard a lot of great things about that manga, and I wanted to read it for a while. So once I found out that a writer had made a smaller work that's similar to Punpun, I decided, you know, why not? Let's get a taste of what his style is before dwelling into his masterpiece, as people say. So anyways, I hope you enjoy my first impressions, and let's get straight into my thoughts. So the first thing I noticed was that the pacing in this is quite fast. It's not too fast to the point where I dislike it, but a lot of things have happened, and I guess it makes sense considering how short the manga is. The romance, for example, starts off really quick, like straight up in the first episodes. These two kids decided they want to bone already without any sort of other pre-sort of context. So it just basically just makes us go headfirst into this story. And it is pretty explicit. I mean, I did not expect this manga to get this explicit. It's basically hentai, you know. There's hardly any censorship. So if you're gonna read this, make sure you're like, you know, at least age appropriate, and you can handle basically a lot of these scenes, is what I'll call it. But aside from that, the art does look pretty beautiful. I really like how he makes a sort of manga style and a sort of realistic style together. It makes the story feel a lot more interpersonal. An example of this would be the girl. I feel like she looks so cute, like she looks so innocent, like a 10-year-old. But then she does, you know, the things she does in this manga. Then it really makes you wonder, huh? How old is she again? And I'm pretty sure this was intentional on their part, because they did mention once in this manga about how she's so innocent. Like, the parents mentioned that themselves. So I'm guessing this is going to be a theme going forward about the innocence of a person. So yeah, so great part on reflecting the theme in your artwork, writer. And aside from the girl, our other main character is the guy. And what can I say? He is tremendously down bad. I haven't seen a guy this down bad since Kasuga from Flowers of Evil. And if you know Kasuga from Flowers of Evil, that's pretty down bad. So, I mean, I don't hate him right now, as long as he gets some sort of character development, but just a quick observation that I got a note. And speaking of Flowers of Evil, this manga is actually really similar to that, and this is not meant to be in any sort of bad or good way, merely just an observation. Like, it has a lot of similar themes, a lot of similar character dynamics, as well as the artwork kind of reminding me of it, in a lot of ways as well. So it does definitely feel like the author, almost the two authors of both mangas, were the same, but they weren't. Another thing I want to mention is the kids' ages, and this I don't know, but I've really started noticing the kids' ages in these mangas and animes ever since Tokyo Revengers, but that's beside the point. And what I'm trying to say here is that despite all the things that are happening, like, how old are they? They're in middle school, last year middle school, so it does seem a little unrealistic, but I'm not gonna give them I'm not gonna say this is some sort of negative on their part, because it does, like I said, mentioned before about the whole theme of innocence. I'm pretty sure this plays in part into why that whole theme, how these kids are really young while still partaking in these acts. So there you go. And I guess the last thing I want to mention is the poem, the initial one. And after reading it, I definitely could tell that this poem has some sort of deeper meaning, and I can already sort of make out what that meaning is, but I will like it if this series does expand on that later on, and I feel like that could be pretty good. Now, onto my potential of this series so far. I think this series has a lot of potential by exploring the teen mind, and like I said, the whole exploring innocence thing. I think that they could really make a good case study about the psychology of a person, as well as the exploration of love. Because let's be honest, the plot of this manga so far, it's basically just the plot of a hentai. There's not much difference. Like, oh, people start boning without actually loving each other, and they have to build to love each other. But unlike hentais, I feel like this manga can actually build upon that and make a meaningful development on that part of the story. And I also feel like the story can be pretty impactful. And I don't know, this is not something I can really relate to anything, but just a sort of intuition I have. I feel like if this story really tells a story in a compact way and gives us just what we want, but not too much, I feel like the story can actually be really good. And I mean really good, not just good. So yeah, I'm looking forward if they can actually pull that off. Anyways, on to some of the negative or bad potential of this series. First one being, of course, if it follows in the same footsteps as The Flowers of Evil. And as you know, my thoughts on The Flowers of Evil, I think was pretty bad, like really, really shit. And if they pretty much does the same thing, like the hateable characters, you know, hateable two leads, the dumb motivations behind them, and the dumb twists that pop up in the story, and pretty much the lack of a meaningful message that just gets shrouded in edginess. If this manga does the exact same thing as that, then I'll be pretty disappointed, but I hope it doesn't. And the only other thing I gotta mention in terms of this category is that this whole manga might not have enough chapters to tell its story. 20 chapters is pretty short, and considering how the story is going, it might seem like it's not, but I'm gonna cross my fingers and hope it is, and I'm gonna put my benefit of the doubt into the author. So there you go, and I hope you enjoyed my video so far. Would I recommend you to read it? It's not for everyone, just like Flowers of Evil, but I will be out back with my review, so look forward to that, and I'll catch you later. Bye.